Hello, everyone. It's an honor to be here, actually, and speak, you know, with all the speakers I've been hearing from morning. And thanks to the organizers for inviting me here, and also for all of you who are here and listening to us despite us being in the way of your lunch. So coming to my talk, what I was here to talk about today in this session of Riches on the Oceans was about the riches on the ocean surface. You know, if I am between plus or minus 1 meter of the ocean surface, what all could I do with the ocean over there? We've all seen this map, I think several times in this conference, about India's exclusive economic zone. So where we started as a company in C6 Energy was actually how to utilize the ocean surface to actually bring about a solution for India's increasing fuel, you know, fuel shortage problem. We import almost all our fuel, and if we could make use of the oceans to actually serve as a means of biomass generation, then this would actually, you know, we wouldn't need to import as much crude as we do today. There's been talk about actually using land-based food stocks, land-based biomass to make a lot of crude oil. But if you look at the scale at which we need fuel today, we simply do not have enough agricultural land to support that. Our agricultural land has actually been declining over the last decade. So if you're going to start making fuel out of that, then, you know, we're obviously going to end up with a question of food versus fuel. Now, while we can talk about ocean agriculture, some of the speakers before have already touched upon the topic of seaweeds. Seaweeds, a plant which grows into the sea, is actually super essential for what I call ocean agriculture. For those of you who may not be aware, the seaweed which I'm, the way we cultivate seaweed is essentially we take a small piece of the seaweed, put it into the water, and just leave it there for about 45 days, and it's increased from, you know, 1 kg to 5 kgs. That's it. There's no input of fresh water, no input of fertilizer, really nothing. If you compare it to agriculture on land, what's limiting agriculture on land? It is the availability of water. And you're never going to be short of water on the sea. So if it was that easy, then why hasn't it happened till today? The answer is yes, ocean agriculture is happening. There is lots of seaweed already being grown. Though not so much in India. Most of it goes into your toothpaste and ice creams. You're just not aware of it. Where it is actually grown in India is in places like Tamil Nadu. And why Tamil Nadu and Gujarat? Because you have areas which are actually quite sheltered. And today the way of cultivation is a farmer literally wades out into the water. He takes this small bit of seaweed, ties it to a line, and then waits for 45 days and then grows it out. If we want to do this across our 7,000 kilometers of coastline, that is not going to work. We've got waves, which in places like Tamil, near Rameshwaram, there's no waves. It's very easy for someone to wade out and actually grow this. So if you look at how agriculture is on the sea today, it's really the stone age of agriculture. How our ancestors, you know, several thousand years ago must have done it. But if we want to modernize it and be, you know, spread it across the coast of India, we need to bring in technology. We need to bring in the equivalent of sea tractors on the ocean so that a farmer is not going in his small boat and harvesting a few kilos of biomass. He can go out in a sea tractor and harvest tons of biomass. And scale is essential for this. And that is where we've been working at C6 Energy. What we're trying to bring in is the equivalent of tractors on the ocean or combined harvesters on the ocean, where if I can show a video. Yeah, it looks like that. Yeah. So here's an animation of our concept where we have a sea tractor actually moving on strips of seaweed farm laid out in the sea. And as it moves forward, it is automatically harvesting the seaweed in front of it while seeding the seaweed behind it. Now, the productivity of the seaweed is so huge as the sea combine moves just barely a few meters, it's already harvesting a ton of biomass. And if you have a ton of biomass, you need to be able to take it and store it because transporting it to land is obviously, it can't be done very soon. So what we've done here is, if you see this part of the animation, where There's a small pipe which is connected from the C-combine onto the mothership, where as it moves forward, it actually chops up the seaweed into small bits and transports it using water where it is stored on the main ship. On the main ship, the seaweed is processed into special intermediaries, which, you know, then can be brought back to shore. Now, this is an animation which we made almost 2 years back. What we see over here is our actual sea tractor in action. It just got launched in December, where we are actually able to go out on the ocean, drive it, harvest seaweeds in large volumes, and produce it. Now, why is this important? Because these are tests which we have done, where you can actually take the sea plant biomass, convert it using HTL, which is high temperature liquefaction of the biomass, and convert it to crude oil. This crude oil can fit into an existing refinery and produce a whole variety of products which, you know, goes into your cars, which can be used for plastics, and the whole lot. But HTL is a technology that's around for a long time. In fact, conversion of biomass into fuel, the technology is well known. The issue has always been, at what price am I going to get the fuel? Who will be willing to pay, you know, 5 times the amount of price for fuel today just because it's going to save the environment? While people have larger goals and vision, nobody is willing to pay it out of their own pocket. But if you look at the inputs of seaweed, you don't need any fresh water for pumping. You don't need to add any fertilizers. It's just a matter of actually mechanizing it. And what we have seen, that if you can bring down the cost of seaweed biomass on a dry basis to lower than $100 a ton, today the price in the market is about $1,500 a ton. So there's no way anyone's going to be making fuel out of seaweed. It's literally burning your money. But what we see is that with the limitless potential of the ocean and bringing in these mechanized systems, we're not only able to produce the biomass at that levels at which fuel becomes feasible, we're also bringing in a whole amount of employment across the coast of India. And why I say employment, today seaweed farming, as speakers have talked about before, is an income generating opportunity. I know that personally because we buy seaweeds from farmers. Although we've not been able to make a lot of fuel to power our cars, we've had our seaweed farmers who have bought cars because of the amount of seaweed they've grown. While seaweed is so lucrative, well, a funny thing which is happening is the children of these successful seaweed farmers don't want to go into the sun and, you know, pick the seaweed and carry it and bring it back. So we have these farmers who are super successful and their children are going to cities like Tuticorin and being a waiter there just because it's a city. So what I would like to see is, can we make seaweed cultivation to such a level that, you know, I could be able to go and do that as a daily job. It's not something. So I'll just be quick then. So advantages of seaweeds, large scale cultivation. I've talked about this, so I'll skip. In order to make biofuel at the level at which India needs, what we will need is this area the size of Tamil Nadu. And as you can see in the whole economic zone, we can easily fit an area of Tamil Nadu to produce enough fuel for India. As I said today, this as the price of seaweed drops, we need to go to $100 a ton of biomass before which biofuel becomes feasible. But even before biofuel becomes feasible, there's a whole lot of other products which kind of can be possible. For example, bioplastics is one very interesting area where we could actually make plastics from the seaweed, which is completely biodegradable. But at today's rate, it's slightly high in cost and maybe used for luxury packaging. But as we bring it down and way before we hit the biofuel prices, it can become mainstream. These are some of the products we've developed at C6 Energy, which includes the biostimulant. And over here is the bioplastic I'm talking about. This is something we've actually made and demonstrated and, you know, waiting for the price to go down. Now, as we were developing systems to farm out large areas of the ocean, the other thing we developed was actually, how do we make an offshore base? Because if you're going to be farming square kilometers of the ocean, you can't be coming back to land for everything you want. So that's where we came up with floating islands. What we call dweeps, which can actually span several from few tens of square meters to even a hectare of the ocean surface using an interesting bit of technology called tensegrity. So here's a prototype of what we've put out, and this prototype is put out near Tuticorin, where the concept of this is you have this island which, even if you have it at the size of a hectare, it's not rigid like a barge. And that is why we're able to make it inexpensive. So when a wave comes, even at wave heights of 6 meters above, there's no problem, the structure will last, but it will actually flex with the wave. And the primary purpose of this is to provide energy in the ocean. So over here, we have put solar panels on the Dweep, and this prototype is intended to put solar panels on it and a RO system so that it will generate fresh water and provide fresh water for, to the local community for free. Now, one of the applications is to put solar power into the sea. What all does that enable? You can have floating offshore habitable islands. So people have been talking about floating resorts, but those are really very small. But if you want several resorts in one island, that is very much possible with floating island technology. You can, if you put solar power in the middle of the sea, even for offshore surveillance or even for drone recharging stations, this is a very good opportunity. I was just talking to the people from IMD outside, and we could, on a floating island like this, you could even put out meteorological stations in the middle of the sea, which is completely autonomous. The other application which we have in these floating islands is we're able to make floating breakwaters. So while these can also serve as energy generation devices, because they are floating islands, you could put them in front of coasts which are facing severe erosion problems, and these actually attenuate the wave energy so that it protects the coast while also providing, a plus over that. So the technology is 100% developed in India, we hope they can have solutions throughout the world. And yes, that is why we call it an ocean of possibilities. Thank you.